almost as if they sung together all their lives. And you couldn't imagine either of them singing separately from each other.
It was natural because they'd always been together, but unnatural to have to follow this career, you know, with someone sort of tied to your hip, you know, like a Siamese twin.
You'd have thought that this was the solid brotherhood of brothers.
Bye bye, happiness.
Hello, loneliness. I think I'm gonna cry.
They lived a very intense, high pressure life when they were extremely young and got pushed very, very hard. They were just pushed to the point of breaking down.
The original family duo, the Everly Brothers, came from poor Kentucky mining stock. Their mom and dad sang country and styled the boys as a duo from the get-go. Although Don was 2 years older than Phil, Mom always dressed the boys in identical sports jackets.
My father said a thing to me. He took us out when we were kids, and he took us one stick and he broke it. And then he took two sticks and put them together, and he says, "Now, see, you can't break these two. Together we had real power."
Well, a great big howdy-do to all of our good friends and neighbors. This is Dad Everly talking for the Everly family.
Their childhood was relatively cut short. They were given a great gift, but in the same sense, they were the providers of the family.
I thought it was a better job than heavy lifting, and which was the alternative.
The Everly Brothers cut their first single, Bye Bye Love, in May 1957. It sold a million and made the boys pop idols overnight.
We bought a 98 Oldsmobile, and at that time there was no speed limit. We were rolling along about as fast as you could go. And Bye Bye Love came on the radio at, and, you know, about midnight, and it was magic.
Hit after hit and tour after tour followed Bye Bye Love. Only Elvis Presley and Buddy Holly could match the Everlys' international success over the next 5 years. But behind the perfect harmonies and matching outfits, the brotherly love was wearing thin.
No one can really make you as angry as a sibling can as quickly. They know all the, just the right button to push.
And you have to be with them 24 hours a day. No wonder they couldn't stand each other.
Now here they are with their latest problems, the Everlys.
Problems, problems.
And you have business managers and accountants.
You can solve my problems.
And there's lots of money involved. I mean, nothing drives a family apart faster than a lot of money.
Older brother Don wrote most of the hits, but the stress and exhaustion also drove him to amphetamines and drink. Come the Beatles in 1963, and almost overnight, the Everlys' clean-cut harmonies were yesterday's news.
America could not lay claim forever to rock and roll. The Beatles went and took it back to the States, and for a time, America was hit between the eyes. Oh, someone else can do this.
The hits dried up, but the boys both had families to support and still toured together relentlessly.
Bye-bye, love.
By 1973, the Everlys were locked in what they later called the Big Southern Feud. They had different managers, stayed in different hotels, and barely spoke. When Don came on stage drunk at Knott's Berry Farm in California, Phil couldn't stand to share a mic with his big brother a moment longer.
My father took his guitar and threw it straight down, smashed it on stage, and walked straight off. And that was it. And he'd had enough.
Now, I don't want somebody to come over to my house and do some hammering and tell me he's having a bad day, therefore he's going to drive the nail crooked. You walk on stage, you do your job, and you do it right. You also go on sober.
I'll never let you see the way my broken heart is hurting.
It was way more than the Everly Brothers. It was the Everly Brothers, as brothers, it was what it was. And that's a very painful wound.
Don and Phil each wrote country hits for other artists and tried to have solo careers. They didn't speak for 10 years.
We didn't see each other at all except during when our father got ill and passed on.
Don had an apartment on Sunset and had a neon sign made which said free. Had that in his living room. And I thought that was quite poignant, you know.
Yet the Everly's music was still all over the radio, and their fans kept asking them to reunite. No one else could sing harmony like Don and Phil. Finally, Don swallowed his pride.
Don kind of called my father, and I think they had to kind of get through the first awkward, how are you? What's going on? Next thing you know, Dad was off to England to Royal Albert Hall to do the reunion concert.
We talked about doing a warm-up gig, you know, rather than going into the Albert Hall cold, you know. Then they just decided against that. They said, well, maybe that'll kind of take away from it.
Reunion in 1983, the Everlys have toured intermittently. Currently, they aren't working together. Let it